Press the bell icon on YouTube and don't miss another update.
We've been talking about Kashmir over the past several days. We'll continue to do that today in Cut the Clutter with one difference. Until now, I've been looking at the situation from the Indian point of view, from the Indian side, our side. Let me try and see it today from the Pakistani side. Why? Because even military men, when they do war games, they look at a situation in terms of what will the other side do. So the Pakistanis were left with very limited options when suddenly the Modi government carried out its changes in Kashmir. Because obviously they had no idea this was happening. They completely missed it. They were in fact made complacent by what they saw as success with Imran Khan's visit to America and also with their army chief and his couple of comrades' visit to America. This was a rare case where the army chief and his two other generals got an audience of their own with Trump, where Pakistan's famous strategic scholar Aisha Siddiqui writes in the print that she thinks that Trump actually flattered them. So while they were enjoying this or savoring this success that Trump has now offered to mediate with India, suddenly India did all this that made all those offers and things completely irrelevant. Now, how did Pakistan react? So let's one look at what they've done and then game their minds and look at their prospects. So what they have done so far is the equivalent of that French police captain in Casablanca saying, okay, somebody's been shot or somebody's run away, round up the usual suspects. So this is just an instinctive reaction which is already scripted on a piece of paper somewhere, piece of paper one third the size of this piece of paper, that downgrade diplomatic relations, stop trade, review other bilateral decisions, close the airspace. We've been in that place several times before in the last 30 years. And why do I say 30 years? Because 2019 is exactly 30 years since this round of troubles in Kashmir began in 1989. So this is something we are familiar with one difference. In these 30 years, each time these methods have been used or these reactions have come from India. The provocation has come from Pakistan. India then immediately has responded in these terms. The difference this time, big difference, that India has caused the provocation and Pakistan has responded this way. So, important point, the initiative for the first time in 30 years is with India. It may be a wise step, may not be a wise step, that's a different debate. But this time, India has lit the spark, Pakistan is responding. So, it's a change of basic equation, the basic tactical equation, I won't say strategic equation. Except the Pakistanis have also done the same thing. I won't be surprised over the next couple of days if some missile tests are carried out, because these are all set-piece reactions. Now, I'm going to tell you why this is not going to work and why this is an empty boast. Because one, we have very little diplomacy that happens at the High Commissioner level. If at all something happens, it happens on the back channel that nobody knows anything about. And I don't believe the back channel will even now shut. I think the back channel is already always on. It was even on the morning after Pulwama when our planes were fighting around Nowshera and Rajouri. So let us see. This doesn't mean anything. There is very little trade between India and Pakistan. There is nothing India imports from Pakistan which is essential for India. There is nothing Pakistan imports from India that is essential for them. Unless, as I am told now, at this point, hara dhaniya, the green coriander, which is very important for all our dishes, is being imported from Pakistan, because it's not quite the dhaniya season in India. It's a winter vegetable in India. But that's only half serious. So all these will make no difference. So what will Pakistan do next? What can they do next? They say they will go to UN Security Council. Fine. I don't believe that any major country today has any patience with any of this. In fact, even in the Islamic world, only two countries in different degrees have come out to support Pakistan. Different degrees means to a lesser degree Malaysia, to a stronger degree or a higher degree, Turkey. But Turkey and Pakistan have had a strategic relationship for quite some time. It's become stronger lately, and that has other complications and other reasons, but let's not go there right now. So it's very unlikely they will find much attention for any noises or breastfeeding that they might do in the UN Security Council now. They'll make big speeches there. Indian side also has many champions who can make even bigger speeches. They will use colorful language. There are people on this side who will use colorful language. UN General Assembly is coming up in just a month from now in September. Tamasha will go on there also. That will make no difference. Then what can they do? This is all diplomatic and trade, etc. What can Pakistan do tactically and strategically? So again, look at the picture from the Pakistani side. Tactically, they can do two things. One, they can up the temperature on the LOC, but they also know it that nobody in India is really bothered. In fact, it doesn't even make the front pages anymore. Even if you carry out a bat action, that is a border action team action, kill a few soldiers on this side, you can be sure that in reasonable time, within hours or within a couple of days, not weeks, more people will be killed, more soldiers will be killed on the other side. You target civilians on this side with artillery, civilians will be targeted on your side with artillery. With equal effect, in fact, with worse effect. So those things tactically will not work. What can they do strategically? Strategically, what can they do is, they can shove more terrorists into India, more jihadis. They can even push it one step ahead and say, this time there will be Pulwama type attacks. And Imran Khan has said so. He said there can be Pulwama type attacks. First of all, nobody is really afraid of those attacks. People get angry in India, but really, India's, even the public opinion is over with that fear. India is done with it. But to make it strategic from tactical, they may push this activity outside of Kashmir into what we might call mainland India, like the attack on Pathankot. Or you can blow up a school, you can blow up a cinema hall, you can blow up a shopping mall for effect. And then think that India will see this is a punishment to us, so let us stop doing other stuff in Kashmir. It's not going to happen like that, because Pulwama has now shown that any such thing will have an immediate and disproportionate reaction in the Pakistani mainland. And what happens after that, you clean up the detritus of that. So again, if I'm looking at it from the Pakistani side, and I'm gaming the Indian response, I will not be encouraged to do any of this, because I know that law of diminishing returns on terror acts of this kind has now set in. Next thing they might try to do strategically is to try and instigate Indian Muslims, who many of whom are angry with Modi government, many of whom feel disenfranchised, many of whom feel disempowered, victimized, but that will take time. But even if something happened there, this Indian establishment and today's Indian public opinion will see it as a Pakistani initiative, and the response will be delivered directly to the Pakistanis on their mainland and not necessarily covertly. And the Pakistanis also know, again, if I'm a Pakistani strategist, I know that right now my underbelly is very soft, because Balochistan I knew how to deal with, and also Balochistan is an armed insurgency. It's much easier for a country to fight an armed insurgency. But what's happening with the Pakhtun people, with the Pashtun movement, it's a peaceful mass movement. It is very difficult to fight a peaceful mass movement. It has a lot more power. Plus, Pakhtuns are very mainstream in Pakistan. They are spread in all the cities. Remember, the largest Pakhtun city in the world is not Kabul or Peshawar, it's Karachi. So this is a very sensitive area. So again, a Pakistani ruler, a Pakistani strategist will be very aware of that. So that there are limitations to that strategy. What this has done is that Pakistan's old tactics, which was the tactics of blackmail with the world, that I have the gun to my head, either listen to me and give me what I want, or I will shoot myself and mess up the table in front of you or your home, you deal with it then. I think the world has now gotten over it. India has called that bluff after Pulwama. The world has gotten over it. Plus, the world is tired and impatient with Pakistan. And Pakistan will have to be aware that even if it started pushing in terrorists, even if it started lighting up the line of control, and God forbid, if it did anything outside of Kashmir of any kind, then all bets are off in terms of its own economic and political future as well, because it's just a month and a half before FATF, Financial Action Task Force, will take a call on Pakistan, because Pakistan there has a list of targets it has to meet by then, and the IMF loan is also linked to that. So my last point now, if I'm again looking at it from the Pakistani side, and I say all these things don't work. These were my roundup, the usual suspects options. They will not work. The use-by date on them is over. What can I do? Frankly, I can do nothing from the Pakistani side. But I can pray. And what will I pray for? If I was a Pakistani strategist, I will pray for the situation on the ground in Kashmir Valley going out of control. Protests going out of control, lots of people coming out, protesting, and somebody in the Indian paramilitary forces or police or within the administration losing his nerve or getting angry and starting to fire and gifting me a mini Jallianwala Bagh. So what the Pakistanis can do right now is only pray for a mass upsurge against which Indian authorities use excessive firepower, and then it becomes impossible to defend internationally, or if there are massive human rights abuses, if this lockdown continues for a long time, because that will turn the global opinion. That can internationalize the issue. So the key to now proceeding smoothly from where India has come right now to getting into a real mess like this lies now entirely with the local administration, the paramilitary forces, the military leadership. The time now is to learn to hold your nerve and hold the fire. Because if you do that, then Pakistanis, I've tried to look at this picture from the Pakistani side, try to get into their minds, I see no options except some usual noise.